Hello, welcome to another of the MachStdMill probing demonstration videos. In this video I want to demonstrate probing for a circular pocket, and I'm also going to demonstrate probe tip calibration to give you an idea of how that works. Now, as we've done in some previous videos, I have MachStdMill running here. Before, we had been on the edge probing operations. I've moved us to the panel that shows us the pocket and post operations, and I have set up in the vise a block with two circular holes in it. What I want to do is I first want to show you the down and over version of the operation for finding the center of a circular pocket, and then we're going to look at the measurements that resulted from that, and I'm going to talk about probe calibration and walk through the probe calibration routines a little bit here and show you how that corrects for some of the error that's introduced by the travel of the probe before it triggers. So let's go ahead and start at the beginning here. You'll notice that it's hard to tell from parallax. What I've got here is I'm just off of the pocket. I'm not anywhere near the center. I'm just some arbitrary place off the edge. But because the down and over operation is going to come down and then move over an X minus, I've just picked some place so that when I move over by the step off distance, I'll be inside the circle when it goes down to probe depth. So what we do is we probe down, find the top surface, move over, come down to probe depth, find one surface of the pocket, along the x-axis go and find a second surface of the pocket. It then finds the center line from there, probes along in the y plus direction, comes back, probes in the y minus direction, takes us to the preliminary center of the pocket and reprobes in the x direction. The second x direction probe takes out cosine error from not being on the center line during the first set of x direction probes. And you'll see that what we've done is we have left ourselves at the center of the circular pocket. So a very convenient way if you need to find the center of a pocket. One button finds it for you here. Now I want to look at some of the results that came as a result of this probing operation. And notice it says the axis have been zeroed to the center, and it says the diameter of this circle happens to be 2.0073. Now that's not the correct diameter for the circle. You might ask, why is that? It turns out that what I have done is that I happen to have a 4 millimeter spherical probe tip on the end of this probe. And 4 millimeters would be 0.1575 in terms of inches, but I have entered the value into the tool table as 0.1565, so it's off by 10 thousandths. And I did that on purpose because when you're just doing a probe operation, the system goes along and it uses the diameter of the probe that you've told it. It doesn't know any better. So how do you take care of these errors? Well, first of all, it would have been much better if I had put in the correct diameter of the probe tip, but I wanted to demonstrate that this showed some things that were off a little bit. So you'll notice that as a probe tip moves, I'm going to turn on the calibration button here. And if you think about it, as you were watching the probe move, as it came down into the center and it moved off to look at the edges, the probe actually has to tilt just a little bit before it triggers. This introduces some error, and so there's a concept that is different. There's the physical diameter of the probe tip and the effective probe tip diameter. And the effective probe tip diameter accounts for the error introduced by the angle that the probe shaft has to move before the probe is triggered. Now, to calculate what this is, what you do is you take a circle of known diameter. In this case, I happen to know that the pocket that I was just probing is in actuality 1.990 inches. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and reprobe this same circle using the calibration mode. In this case, the system is going to say, I know what the diameter of the circle is. I'm going to go ahead and measure it, and then I'm going to calculate the difference between the known measurement and the measured amount, and then we're going to use that as tip compensation. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm not going to use the down and over this time because I'm already at probe depth, so I'm just going to click probe center and we'll watch it do another circular probe operation. In this case, it's done the X again. It doesn't know that it's not on center line, so it does X, does Y, and it'll come back and do the second X in order to take out cosine errors in case it had been off center the first time. So one more probe to the other side. Now when we come back, I'm going to have to move this dialog box out from underneath my video window. You'll notice that what it currently has, it says my current probe tip compensation was zero, and my new tip compensation is, happens to be negative. That's the way it comes out depending upon whether you're probing inside or outside here, but about 17 thousandths. Now that's about what I would expect. 0.001 of that is the fact that I told her the diameter was wrong to begin with, and about 0.007 is due to travel of the probe before it actually triggers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell it to replace the old value of tip compensation with the new value for tip compensation. If you're doing this multiple times, you can also average them so that you can do this many times and zero in on a more precise value, but I'm just going to replace it in this case. It says, okay, I have updated the value that's in your tool table. Do you want to save the tool table now? And I'm going to say yes. Go ahead and save that value. Now, you'll notice that in having measured that, it thinks the thing was 2 inches. But now that we have a calibrated probe, let's go ahead and measure the same pocket again. Only this time we know what the correct diameter is, including the over travel for the probe tip. So away we go again, doing X, doing Y. And we will do the final X direction probe for the circle. Okay, we have finished this. Now this time it's much more interesting. Let's come down and look at the X and Y width. They ought to be the same since we're measuring a circle, right? In one case I get 1.987, in the other case I get 1.992. Now, these aren't going to be precise in this particular example here for a couple of different reasons. I'm using a probe for demonstration here where I have not gone to the trouble recently to get the probe tip centered in the along the z-axis, if you will, so there is some offset error in here in X and Y because I haven't got the probe tip perfectly aligned and centered. So the calibration routine will compensate for differences in diameter, but it does assume that you have the probe tip centered, and this demonstrates the importance of going through the proper calibration procedures, and that when you mount probes that you always mount them in the same relative rotational position in your spindle, and also that you get out the offset, because Mach does not have a way to compensate for offset errors this way. But even with a little bit of offset that I've got in this thing, you'll notice that the actual value is 1.99 and I'm at 1.987. I'm within 0.003 roughly there, and 1.992, 0.002 the other direction. And that's not bad for an econo probe that is in the slightly over $100 range here, not perfectly calibrated. So this gives you a pretty good idea that a lot of folks are getting accuracy within a couple of tenths using these inexpensive probes. And the probe tip calibration routine really does help you make better measurements here. So that's the circular pocket and how you use it for calibration. I will note that you can also probe the center of a circular extrusion or a post. You can also use the post for calibration purposes. It works the same way. Just turn the calibration button and then click the post center finding routine. But I'm going to go ahead and stop here. That covers our circular pockets and the calibration using a circular pocket. And in the next one of these videos, I'm going to come and handle rectangular pockets. We're going to talk about rectangular extrusions and circular extrusions as well. That'll cover the major operations that are here in the pocket and post set. Before I leave this video, I do want to note that you'll see two buttons here, first C and last C. I've had both of those turned on for all these operations. That is the normal state of operation for MachStdMill for these probing operations. But if you were probing something, for example, one of the extrusions which had a hollow center, it is possible to individually control first C and last C as to when it probes for the center of the horizontal surface. I'll refer you to the manual for more information about those things, but there's quite a bit of flexibility here so that you can actually end up probing things that are hollow and still finding the center of them even though they're extrusions and you wanted to find them from the outside edges rather than the inside edges of the pocket. That's the end of the first video here. We'll see you in some of the subsequent videos.